President Rodrigo Duterte is expected to announce Thursday night new quarantine classifications as COVID-19 cases in the country surpass 85,000 before the end of July. When asked whether the increase in transmission will mean a stricter lockdown for Metro Manila, the palace has this to say.
Well, yes and no. I will not preempt the president. Pero gaya ng sinabi ko, it will not be business as usual.
Earlier, Malacanang announced that the government will implement major changes in its COVID-19 response. This amid strong criticisms over its lack of a solid plan to address the pandemic. Presidential spokesman Harry Roque said this means more aggressive efforts towards COVID-19 testing, contact tracing, isolation, and treatment.
Habang pinapainting natin ang testing, naghahanda tayo ng mas maraming isolation facilities at ginagawa nating agresibo ang tracing. At siyempre po, pagdating sa treatment, kumukuha po tayo ng high-flow cannula at yung mga gamot na napatunayan na nagpapababa po ng mga taong namamatay dahil po sa COVID-19.
Malacanang announced it will soon pilot in Metro Manila pooled testing, which will drastically increase the efficiency and capacity in conducting COVID-19 tests in the country. With pooled testing, samples collected from a group of 10 individuals will be tested as one.
Sa pamamagitan po kasi ng pooled testing, mamumultiply natin by 10 yung ating actual testing capacity.
Ito ay napaka-importante dahil mabababa natin ang malaki ang cost ng testing pag ito'y ginawa natin. At ikagawa, mas mabilis at mas madami tayong matitest. At yun ang gusto nating gawin.
The government says it is also working to construct new health isolation centers as well as increase ICU beds, especially in big hospitals in Metro Manila. Government's chief implementer of the COVID-19 response, Secretary Carlito Galvez, says as the country moves to the second phase of its COVID-19 response, more focus will be given to the responsibility of the LGUs, the private sector, and even individuals in addressing the threat of the pandemic while balancing the gradual reopening of the economy.
Kung titingnan po natin sa ating mga datos, ay pataas na pataas ang ating mga new cases. Ito po ay dahil sa niloosen up natin ang restrictions at the same time, nagkaroon po tayo ng tinatawag na opening ng economy. So ito po ay isa sa mga challenges po natin on how we could address this emerging issue.
Galvez says the government is also coordinating with different countries to ensure the supply of COVID-19 vaccines once it becomes available in the market. China earlier assured the Philippines it will give the country priority in the procurement of a vaccine following an appeal by President Duterte to Chinese President Xi Jinping. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.